Beauty, it's Vicky J here. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to all my subscribers and my new ones. It's always a pleasure to have you. So today I'll be talking a little bit about shedding, and we all know that is part of the hair care process and the cycle that our hair goes through, and it's something that sometimes we just kind of like bypass a little bit, you know, and we may mistake it just for a regular day of just combing our hair and, you know, just finding things. But you know, we have to look a little deeper into this, and shedding is a normal part of the hair care cycle. And what shedding is really noticing the separation of your hair. When you're combing your hair, you might find it in your combs or your brushes. You can even find it on your pillowcases when you're sleeping, or even on your clothes. You know, these are hair that are detached from your scalp, and you will just find them in these places. And you know, sometimes you may see them in small amounts, or you may see them in larger amounts, all depending. Now, hair shedding is a normal part of the hair growth cycle, and it's an ongoing process because hair is not synchronized, meaning that hair does not grow or shed at the same point in time, and not all of our hair are in the same growth cycle. Because if our hair was synchronized and was shedding all at the same time, we will be bald. And by this happening, it helps to maintain a consistency of the density of our hair, meaning that if some of our hair has already gone through the growth cycle and shedded, we still have hair to back us up. You know, we're not losing everything at the same time. And that's what I'm talking about. If we were to shed all of our hair at the same time, we will be bald. So with the growth cycle that our hair goes through and the phases and stuff, you know, it allows us to still shed some hair with the maintenance of our hair and keeping the density of our hair at a normal, good pace. When hair does shed, it means that it had already gone through its growth cycle and, you know, it's gonna be replaced by new hairs. Now, hair shedding is a normal process throughout the hair growth cycle, and we do shed about 50 to 100 strands of hair a day. I know that sounds like a lot, because I will not like to be combing my hair and see just like all these strands just hanging out on the combs or the brushes, you know, even on the floor, things like that. But it is a normal cycle, and we do shed this amount of hair. It is just the main medium as far as the amount of hair we will shed. I mean, if you're not constantly manipulating your hair and doing things with your hair, you will not see this on a daily basis. But as far as having a healthy, normal hair cycle and maintenance to your hair, this is possibly something you could see either within that amount or less. You know, it doesn't have to be that huge amount, but that's just the within range. Anything a lot more than that is considered to be excessive shedding, and nobody really wants to go through excessive shedding, because as I said, combing out a lot of your hair and you're just looking at the comb, looking at the brush, and you're seeing all of that hair, all of your hair strands in there, you will be panicking. You will be having a breakdown to be seeing all of your hair in the comb or in the brush or even on the floor. So you will be going into panic mode just seeing your hair on these areas and not where it should be. So when you're going through this excessive type of shedding, there is a medical term that is used to describe this, and it's called telogen effluvium. It's a temporary cause of shedding in the hair, and it usually occurs within the top area of the head, more like the crown area. So this is where it's really going to be noticeable. And that is just more like if you're into an excessive form of shedding. This usually occurs due to some type of shock or stress mainly. We know that stress is the main cause sometimes of, you know, hair shedding, or some type of trauma. Now, shedding usually takes place, you know, when you're washing your hair, you know, you're shampooing, you're going up in there, sometimes you're combing your hair out in the shower. And when you look back, you see that, you know, the drain is just, you know, filled up with your hair. That is a form of shedding. And I mean, even though we all supposed to have this shedding throughout the hair growth cycle, you just don't want to see these in any kind of major amount. So if you're noticing that whenever you're washing your hair, like there's more hair falling out, or even when you're combing it out, you're seeing like, you know, there's a little more than usual, you know, these are red flags for you to be paying attention to. Now, for you to know when a hair is shedded and, you know, to know exactly what you're actually looking for, you know, you just take one of the hair strands, you analyze it, and you look for the bulb at the end of the hair. Now that's the part that's actually anchored into the scalp itself, and this is going to be a little white area to the end of the hair. That white bulb indicates that the hair has gone through its full growth cycle, and that can result in shedding of the hair. So you know, always pay attention when you see your hair, even in your combs and your brushes, how long the hair is, and even looking for the bulb at the end of the hair, you know, because sometimes, you know, people can misconstrue shedding for breakage. Those are two different things, and I will touch on that topic another time. But as far as shedding, you're always supposed to find a bulb at the end of the hair, because the hair itself, when it sheds, it's going to shed the entire length of hair from the scalp. This entire hair will be separated from the scalp, and you will find that little bulb at the end of the hair. That is a shedded hair. The entire length of hair with the bulb attached, that is a shedded hair. Now, a few common reasons why you may be shedding. It could be probably chemical processing, which means, you know, meaning it's relaxed or it's color treated. Now, this is where the hair is more vulnerable for these types of issues to take place, because the hair is more in a weaker form. Because when you relax your hair or you do color treatments, you know, the bonds in the hair are being broken down to accommodate this chemical, and that can cause the hair to become a little weaker, resulting in any of these issues. Not saying that this is something that will happen all the time, but with proper maintenance and taking care of your hair, whether it's color treated or you use any type of chemicals in the hair, you know, you're not supposed to see any of these situations in excessive forms. But you will do shed, but at the same time, you know, you will not be shedding excessively if not well maintaining the hair. See, the change of seasons can also have an effect on your hair. Winter, summer, spring, fall can really put a toll on the hair. I know me personally, winter time, usually that kind of causes my hair to become a little more vulnerable to the cold temperatures. So, you know, you look at the seasons and you see exactly how your hair handles these weather. And this can also be a reason that, you know, your hair can be going through such a process. Another reason that you can be having some shedding is over styling your hair, meaning that you're using tight ponytails, you're pulling your hair back too tight where it's actually pulling the scalp and causing a lot of trauma, allowing the hair to detach from the root. Or you can just be combing your hair a little too rough, brushing your hair too rough, or just using uncomfortable head ties on your head. That can also cause you to have some shedding to your hair as well. So, you know, you have to really pay attention to what you're really doing with your hair and not putting too much pressure or tension on the hair itself, because all of these things can really weaken the hair and cause you to have shedded hair. Now, even though, you know, you might be hearing about shedded hair and you may notice little things that's going on with yourself, you know, sometimes it's not good to just self-diagnose and say, oh, your hair is shedding and this and that is the case and you're going to use this product or that product. You know, I always advise that, you know, you follow up with your primary care physician to get further in depth to understand why you're probably going through a situation, because it may not just be from styling, or it may not just be from the weather, or it may not just be from chemicals and things like that. You know, it could be some other underlying cause that you may not know. So in certain situations, if you can get to your doctor first and try to weigh out the situation, it will be good to get, you know, proper medical advice before going and starting your own routine of self-diagnosis and using products or even supplements to adhere to the situation. The best way to slow down or even stop any type of shedding that you may be going through is to cut back on chemical uses and also cut back on over styling the hair. I've just mentioned that before. You know, these are two main things that can really stress the hair out and make it vulnerable. You can also start taking some type of supplements, and as I previously mentioned, getting advice from a medical professional is the best way to go before starting using any of these supplements that you can even purchase over the counter. You know, always follow up with your doctor first before using anything of this sort, as far as like inducing, putting it into your body and things like that. Because as far as shedded hair, you know, there's a couple of things that you can buy over the counter, and we all know this one, and it's biotin. It is a water soluble, it is a B vitamin that you can use that can, you know, help to boost and strengthen up the hair. You can also use vitamin A as to adhere to strengthening and rejuvenating the hair. Now, vitamin A has retinoids, which actually increases the growth of the hair. And it also assists with sebum production that helps to coat the hair with its natural oils, you know, to maintain its moisture and to keep the scalp moisturized as well. You can also try using a lot of moisturizing conditioners that's gonna help to add moisture to the hair. And even maybe a scalp scrub, something that's gonna exfoliate the scalp, you know, to actually lift any type of buildup, you know, to allow air to get to the scalp. Because when your scalp is healthy, the follicles are gonna be able to hold on a lot better, you know, so you don't have much shedding, you know. So a healthy scalp is a happy scalp. So you want to make sure that you have a nice clean scalp to maintain the follicles and make them stay on your head. You don't want them in your combs, you don't want them in your brushes. You do not want your hair just laying on the floor and not on your head, because it's very stressful. It's very, very stressful. And stress is a major factor that can apply to you losing some hair or your hair just shedding. And one more thing I want to touch on is that when combing your hair, and I had mentioned this before, always comb your hair, you know, like in a bathtub or in a sink or something like that, so you can see the hair that's falling out. You know, a lot of times I know you guys like to go in the mirror and you're like, you're combing and you're shaking and you're fluffing and all of this stuff. You don't know what's falling on the floor, you know, you're just looking at what's in your comb or what's in your brush, but that's not enough. You know, so always back comb your hair at the edge of the tub. That's something that I always do. Have a hair journal. Whether you're on a hair journey or you're just taking care of your hair, it's good to write things down, you know, so you can revert back to it. And it's helped me a lot through my hair journey, you know, so you can revert to it on a later day, so you can see what you actually did to help the situation. So I hope this video was a little helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching. So do comment, like, and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that bell on your way out to be notified of all my future videos. And I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.